In this video, we're going to start building our SAF 7-inch freestyle quadcopter. I've got the parts laid out here that we're mostly going to be using for this. So in this video, what we're going to be doing is putting the basic frame together, using some damping grease to help us along with that. And then we'll also make sure that we can put the motors on as well. Now, anytime you start building any new quadcopter, it's a good idea to pull out all of the parts first and make sure that you actually have everything that you need. Now, I've already done that, and you can kind of see here in the film that I've separated different items into different piles so I know what's there. Typically a good thing to do. You don't want to get halfway through the build and find out that you're missing some screw or that you have used the wrong bolt in the wrong place and you shouldn't have done that. If you're getting an open source frame, which this is, this SAF open source frame, which you can get at CNC drones, you'll get the carbon parts. You'll get the basic hardware and things that you need in order to be able to build it, but it's probably not going to be all separated into little bags saying that, you know, these particular bolts here are for this purpose and these ones are for that purpose. So you're going to have to do a little bit of separating. To help you out with that, what you can basically always know is that you're going to have standoffs inside the build here, like these here, and whatever bolts you use for those standoffs, they're going to be the same all the way through. So the ones that you use here and here and here and here, they're all going to be the same length typically. And so if you're kind of wondering which screws to use or which bolts to use in which place, you can start by looking at places that are common and where you'll be using the same ones repeatedly. So for example, when you're putting the motors on, the length of the bolts for these motors will all be the same. And so that will help you start to sort out the parts that you need. We're going to need a 2mm hex screwdriver plus the parts. So we can see that these fit together essentially like so. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take the damping grease, very, very small amounts of it, and we're going to put it on every surface where the carbon will touch. And that just provides a nice layer of this damping grease between the two pieces of carbon so that any vibrations get stopped in the damping grease. Here's the very bottom plate we're going to need to put on the inside of it here, where those will touch. Then we will put it on the tops of all of the arms, the bottoms of all of the arms, and on the plate here. And that will be all we need to do. This Nigel grease is very, very thick and sticky. And so to do this, you're going to want to have yourself something like a toothpick or something similar. And then I just use an old, I don't know what you call this, like a bread bag clip, so that you can then just smear the excess grease off and just get a very, very thin layer on there. This needs to be thin, not thick. So we'll just take a little dab here. You can see that there's really not very much on there, and I'm just going to put it on the carbon like this. I'm going to take my flat piece of plastic and just rub that across. It needs a little bit more, but not a lot. You just want to make sure that there's a nice thin coat across the entire surface. And then you can go back the other way. And there you go. That's all there is to it. It's nothing more complicated than that. You can see that it's a very, very thin layer. There's not big glumps and globs on there at all. And that's all you're going to want. So that's one side of one. And we'll just keep doing all the rest here. Now, this damping grease is not 100% necessary at all, especially on a smaller quad. However, on these larger quads, like 7 inches and larger, it really, really helps with reducing vibrations and allowing you to tune your quad so that it flies more smoothly. However, if you don't have it or you can't find it, don't sweat it. All right, so far I've only put this on the one surface. I'm going to do the underside too, but I need some place to put them, so I'm going to grease this part up here so I can lay them on top of each other properly without spreading grease all over the place. Again, I'm just trying to put it only where the carbon is going to be touching. Don't need the grease elsewhere. It just would make a big mess. So now that just lets me temporarily put these greased pieces on here without having to worry about sticking everything else up. If you don't have anything flat, I mean, probably you shouldn't use your wife's credit card for this. Unless you're going broke because of it. Because if you do that, it'll never work again. But not bad. I wiped off most of the excess on there. You don't want big lumps and glumps and globs of it. And we'll go back to the arms here, do the second side. Now, thankfully, you only ever have to do this once, unless you break an arm and have to replace it. Once you've done this, that grease is in there and will continue to do its job as long as you leave it together. Now, what I have here is I have all of the parts. They have the damping grease on both sides of the arms. This plate here, which holds it in from the bottom, has the damping grease on the one side it needs, as does the main plate there. So we just need to put it all together. When you're first putting them together, don't crank them down all the way. More than likely, you're going to need to make some small adjustments as you're tightening everything up. And so just getting them to the point of being snug but not tight at the beginning is a good idea. And that will still let you have a little bit of wiggle room if you need to adjust anything. I did something wrong here. That's what I did wrong. These long ones don't go there. These long ones go at the back. That's why you sort out all of your stuff first and do a dry fit. So you have a good sense of where all of the things are supposed to go to begin. And I just put those two in the wrong place. So take them out, put in the proper ones. Now, what you're going to do to finish this part off is we just originally gently tightened these down so that we could make sure that we could move and flex things around as we were putting all the bolts in place. Now's the time when you're going to go back and secure them fairly firmly. Whenever you do this, you don't need to go absolutely, you know, King Kong kind of crazy on it. Just get them good and snug. And that'll be enough. And that is all you need to do in order to put the basic part of the frame together. Now, the next part is going to be to put the motors on and have them, the wires coming running up through here. So here we have the motors that I'm going to be using for this particular build. These are Emax Eco 2 2807 motors. They're a well-regarded motor. They're affordable, durable, powerful, all of those nice things that we want in our motors. Now, if you want, you can actually put a drop of damping grease on the foot of each of these, which will help reduce the vibrations through here as well. So I am going to do that, but again, it's totally optional. I mean, you don't need much when you do this either. It's always just a little. And I'll put it close to where the holes are on the frame as well, so that it will be touching everywhere. For me, and especially with a large quad like this, I prefer to use, I guess these are called a cup head bolt like this for the motors, rather than a button head like this. And the reason is these are far more durable. If you scrape one of these on the concrete a few times, the button heads, you can wear them right off, and then it's almost impossible to actually take them out again if you need to. And so I'm going to use these cap head bolts. So really simple, just pop it through and screw them together. Now the really key thing here when you're doing this, and I'll show you as I do it once I get this going, is you do not want and in this case it doesn't happen, but you do not want the bolt, let me see how close I can get this here, the bolt to come through past the top of the motor. If that bolt comes through and starts to touch the copper that's in here, you can run into real problems and ruin the motor. So you've got to make sure that your bolts do not go up and touch the motor windings at all. Okay, so we've got one in there right now. Got that grease on my fingers, it's super sticky. And, oops, just gotta adjust this a little bit. There we are. And there we go. For right now, I'm just holding it in place with two. I'm going to put all of them on and then we'll come back and take a look. So, what have we accomplished here? What we've accomplished is putting together of the frame and mounting on the motors so that from here we can now go into installing the electronic speed controller and the other electronics and completing on the build. I think for this particular video, seeing how the basic frame got put together and how you can get the motors put on will be enough. In the next video, we're going to take a look at putting on the ESC, attaching the battery leads, and putting in some of the other electronics. So thank you very much for watching this video until now. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions or anything you want to comment on, please leave a comment down in the comments below. If you found this video interesting and helpful so far, and you would like to see the rest of the build, please consider subscribing. I'd look forward to seeing you in the next videos. Until then, enjoy your day and safe and happy flying wherever it happens to be.